Hey guys, type 2 diabetes is a health condition which means that there is too much sugar circulating in your bloodstream. This is something that can be measured with a simple blood test. You can get a snapshot of your blood sugar levels at a single point in time by measuring your blood glucose. This is often done after 8 or more hours without eating and is called fasted glucose. However, this test can be influenced by the food that you've eaten in the 48 hours before the test, and a longer term and more stable measurement is something called HbA1c. HbA1c is short for hemoglobin A1c, and an HbA1c test measures the amount of glucose attached to your hemoglobin. What is hemoglobin? It's part of your red blood cells. They have an average lifespan of 120 days. So by measuring your HbA1c, you can infer your average blood glucose levels over the last 2 to 3 months. HbA1c is a really common blood test that physicians will use to help diagnose diabetes. If you are at a higher risk of diabetes, your doctor may order this as part of a regular checkup. Otherwise, home testing kits are available for around £40, and those require a sample of blood via a finger prick. There are certain factors that can increase your risk of having type 2 diabetes, and those include being overweight or obese, having a sedentary lifestyle, eating a diet rich in sugary and processed foods, having a family history of type 2 diabetes, being over the age of 45, and certain ethnicities like South Asians are at an increased risk. If you tick one or more of those boxes and are yet to have your HbA1c measured, then it's worth getting yourself checked. Common symptoms to watch out for include frequent urination, particularly at night, increased levels of thirst, tiredness, and losing weight without trying. Longer term, it can be a really serious condition leading to heart attack, stroke, and amputations. If you want an indication of your risk levels, Diabetes UK have a risk assessment questionnaire on their website, which I've linked below, where you can enter your sex, age, ethnicity, family history, waist, height, weight, and blood pressure, and it will give you a risk score out of a possible 47. It also breaks down the level of risk associated with each of your possible answers. In developed nations, it's estimated that 1 in 3 people living with type 2 diabetes don't even know that they have it, and 1 in 9 of the adult population have pre-diabetes. There are certain health conditions where the result of the HbA1c test may not be accurate. This includes people with pancreas or kidney problems, those who are HIV positive, taking medication affects blood glucose, and anyone recently or currently pregnant. If you don't have any contraindications, the following values are used to categorise your result. The normal range is anything under 6% or 42 millimoles per mole. Within that, an optimal range exists between 4.5 and 5.4%. You may be considered pre-diabetic between 6 and 6.4%. And above that would be diabetes, so 6.5%, which is 48 millimoles per mole or higher. This test may not be enough in isolation to give you a diagnosis of type 2 diabetes. Additionally, some doctors like to measure both glucose and insulin as part of something called an oral glucose tolerance test in order to measure trends towards pre-diabetes and catch it nice and early. HbA1c is only measuring a 3-month window, so it makes sense to track it over time. If you are optimal, that may mean just testing yourself once a year. The closer you are to pre-diabetes or diabetes, the shorter the time window in which you could potentially reach that. I've been tracking my HbA1c levels since 2014, and the results can be seen here. I would consider my diet to be generally healthy, and I exercise frequently. Yet at one point my HbA1c was as high as 39 millimoles per mole, with 42 being the start of pre-diabetes. If you do take a home test and find that you classify as pre-diabetic or even diabetic, you will need to get in touch with a doctor who will hopefully prescribe some interventions to help treat it. Thank you for watching.